Morning friends, today let us discuss one of the important topics in pair of straight lines, that is bisector of angles, equations of the bisector of angles, that is bisector of acute angle, bisector of obtuse angle. See friends, this is L1 is equal to 0 and this is L2 is equal to 0 or two lines. This is the acute angle less than 90. This is obtuse angle, that is angle lies between 90 and 180. Right friends? So this is the acute angle bisector. This is obtuse angle bisector. Now we are going to find the equations of these two bisectors. So say the two lines are a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. And a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 are the given two lines. So then equations of the bisectors of the angles given by a1x plus b1y plus c1 by root of a1 square plus b1 square, that is equal to plus minus a2x plus b2y plus c2 upon a2 square plus b2 square. These are the equations of the bisectors of acute angle and obtuse angle. So if you take plus, you get one equation, one bisector, and by taking minus, you get another bisector. Right, friends? So, between these two bisectors, by taking plus, you get one bisector. By taking minus, you will get another bisector. So, between these two bisectors, which is acute angle bisector and which is obtuse angle bisector? For this, friends, you have to do A1 A2 plus B1 B2. A1 A2 plus B1 B2. Before this friends, to find the either acute angle bisector or obtuse angle bisector, the first thing you have to see is both C1 and C2 must be positive. C1 and C2 must be positive. That is the first step you have to take. Both C1 in the given two equations, both C1 and C2 must be positive. If they are by default positive, no problem. If one is minus, then by multiplying with minus, you have to make it plus. So, see that both C1 and C2 are plus. First thing you have to see, C1 and C2 are positive. C1 and C2 are positive. And the second thing, now I am going to tell you. After this, you find the value of A1 A2 plus B1 B2. If A1 A2 less than 0, A1 A2 less than 0, if A1 A2 less than 0, by taking positive sign, by taking plus sign, you will get acute angle bisector, and by taking minus, you will get obtuse angle bisector. Clear friends? A1 A2 plus B1 B2 say less than 0. A1 A2 plus B1 B2 less than 0. Then to get acute angle bisector, we have to take plus. To get obtuse angle bisector, we have to take minus. And the reverse is, if A1 A2 plus b1 b2 greater than 0, a1 a2 plus b1 b2 greater than 0, then by taking minus you get acute angle bisector, and by taking plus you get obtuse angle bisector. This table, this small box, you have to remember, friends. Less than 0, you have to take plus for acute or minus for obtuse. If it is greater than 0, you have to take minus for acute and plus for obtuse. So this table you have to follow. See, sometimes the question will be very specific. Find the acute angle bisector or find the obtuse angle bisector. Okay, friends. After this, the next question is, the next point is, equation of the bisector which contains the origin. This is another important thing, friends. Equation of the bisector which contains the origin. See, friends, remember one thing. Bisector, by taking plus sign, bisector of the angle, by taking plus, always contains the origin. So if you want that thing, you have to do always bisect. You have to remember this point. What is this point? Bisector by taking plus sign always contains the origin. So next problems, I tell you once again that point. So this is one thing, friends. And the other thing is, and the last thing for today's session is, see, equation of the bisector which contains the point x1, y1. See, to get this one, you have to find the values of a1x1 plus b1y1 plus c1 and a2x1 plus b2y1 plus c2. You have to find the values of these two things. a1x1 plus b1y1 plus c1, a2x1 plus b2y1 plus c2. You have to find these two values. If these two values have the same sign, if these two signs have the same sign, then the bisector by taking plus, contains the given point. If these two things have opposite sign, then the bisector by taking minus will contain that point. Right, friends? So, equation of the bisector which contains, say, point x1, y1. You have to find the values of these two things. a1x1, b1, y1 plus c1, a2x1 plus b2, y1 plus c2. You have to find these two values. If these two values have the same sign, that is either less than 0 or both greater than 0, then the bisector by taking plus contains the point. And if these two have the opposite sign, then the bisector by taking minus will contain that point. Right, friends? So, hope you are clear. So, let us see some problems on this. See, first problem, friends. The bisector of the acute angle between 3x minus 4y plus 7 is equal to 0. 3x minus 4y plus 7 is equal to 0. And the other equation is 12x plus 5y minus 2. 12x plus 5y minus 2 is equal to 0. We want the bisector of acute angle. We want the bisector of acute angle. The first thing what we have to do, friends, we have to see that both C1 and C2 are positive. So let us multiply this equation with minus sign. We get minus 12x minus 5y plus 2 is equal to 0. So now both C1 and C2 are positive. What is the next step, friends? We have to find the value of A1 A2 plus B1 B2. Okay. A1 A2, 3 into minus 12. Minus 36 plus B1 B2 minus 4 into minus 5 plus 20, that is equal to minus 16. Minus 16 less than 0. So A1 A2 plus B1 B2 is less than 0. When A1 A2 plus B1 B2 less than 0, then bisector by taking plus is the acute angle bisector. Okay, friends. So now let us get that 3x minus 4y plus 7 by root of a1 square plus b1 square, 3 square plus 4 square, 25, 5 is equal to minus 12x minus 5y plus 2 by root of a square plus b square. 12 square plus 5 square means 169, root 13. Let us cross multiply. 39x minus 52y plus 91 is equal to minus 60x minus 25y plus 10. So 99x minus 27y plus 81 is equal to 0. We can divide by 9. So 11x minus 3y plus 9. 11x minus 3y plus 9 is equal to 0 is the required equation, friends. Okay, friends, let us do one more problem. What is the obtuse angle bisector? What is the obtuse angle bisector of the lines x plus y minus 5? X plus y minus 5 is equal to 0 and x minus 7y. X minus 7y plus 7 is equal to 0. We have to get the obtuse angle bisector. See, the first thing, C1 and C2 must be positive. So let us multiply the first equation with minus. Minus x minus y plus 5 is equal to 0. Now C1 and C2 are positive. Fine. The next step is finding A1 A2 plus B1 B2. A1 A2 minus 1 into 1 minus 1 plus minus 1 into minus 7 plus 7 minus 1 plus 7 6. 6 greater than 0. So A1 A2 plus B1 B2 greater than 0. If A1 A2 plus B1 B2 greater than 0, then by taking plus sign, we get the obtuse angle bisector. Friends, as per the table I have just given. So if A1 A2 plus B1 B2 greater than 0, then by taking plus we get the obtuse angle bisector. Okay, friends, let us find minus x minus y plus 5 by root of 1 square plus 1 square minus 1 whole square minus 1 whole square. Root 2 is equal to x minus 7y plus 7 by root of 1 plus 49, root 50. Root 50 means pi root 2. Root 2, root 2 gets cancelled. Minus 5x minus 5y plus 25 is equal to x minus 7y plus 7. Minus 6x plus 2y plus 18 is equal to 0. It again implies 6x minus 2y minus 18 is equal to 0. By dividing with 2, we get 3x minus y minus 9 is equal to 0. 3x minus y minus 9 is equal to 0. This is the required equation. 3x minus y minus 9 is equal to 0. Okay, friends, let us see one more problem. For the straight lines 4x plus 3y, 4x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. 4x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. And 5x plus 12y plus 9 is equal to 0. Find the equation of the bisector of the angle which contains the origin. We know, friends, where origin contains. Bisector, by taking plus sign, contains the origin. Okay, first let us make C1 and C2 positive. Minus 4x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. First thing over. And second thing, a1 a2 plus b1 b2 minus 4 into 5 minus 20 plus minus 36 minus 56 minus 56 less than 0 minus 56 less than 0. So a1 a2 plus b1 b2 less than 0. Right, friends? If a1 a2 plus b1 b2 less than 0, by taking plus, we get the acute angle bisector. So, now we have to find the value of equation of acute angle bisector. Because a1 a2 plus b1 b2 less than 0, then acute angle bisector contains the origin. Okay, friends? Right. Minus 4x minus 3y plus 6 by root 5 is equal to 5x plus 12y plus 9 by 13 minus 52x minus 39y plus 78 is equal to 25x plus 60y plus 45 minus 77x minus 99y plus 78 plus 33 is equal to 0. It again implies 77x plus 99y minus 33 is equal to 0. By dividing with 11, friends, 7x plus 9y minus 3. 7x plus 9y minus 3 is equal to 0. This is the bisector. This is the region of bisector which contains the origin. Okay, friends, let us take the last problem for today's session.
x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. 5x plus 12y 5x plus 12y plus 9 is equal to 0.
Friends, here what we want is equation of the bisector which contains the point 1 comma 2. Which contains the point 1 comma 2. So friends, the first thing what we should do is C1 and C2 must be the same. So minus 4x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. And now let us find A1, A2 plus B1. Now we want the bisector equation which contains the point 1 comma 2. Which contains the point 1 comma 2. For that what we have to do, we have to find A1x1 plus B1 plus C1 and A2x plus B2y plus C2. And see, first let us find that A1 into x1. See, the equation is minus 4x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. Point is 1 comma 2. A1 x1 B1 y1 plus C1 that is equal to minus 4 less than 0. Now let us take 5x plus 12y plus 9. 5 into 1, 5 plus 12 into 2, 24 plus 9, that is equal to 38, greater than 0. So, A1x1 plus B1 plus C1 and A2x1 plus B2 plus C2 have the opposite signs. So, if these two have the same sign, then we have to take plus. These two have the opposite sign, so therefore we have to take minus. To get the bisector equation which contains the point 1, 2. Okay, friends. Minus 4x minus 3y plus 6 by 5 is equal to minus of 5x plus 12y plus 9 by 13. Minus 52x minus 39y plus 78 is equal to minus 25x minus 60y minus 45. So minus 25x minus 52x minus 27x plus 21y plus 123 is equal to 0. It again implies 27x minus 21y minus 123 is equal to 0. We can divide by 9. 9x minus 7y minus 41 is equal to 0. 9x minus 7y minus 41 is equal to 0 is the required equation, friends. Okay, friends. See you. Let us discuss some more problems in the next session. Thank you.